I think we're ready whenever you are.
The gym is crazy loud. There's such a strong sense of pride and pure excitement, radiating from it so much that you have goosebumps. The score is 24-23, and you need one more point to win it all. The serve is up, and bam, it comes straight to you. You make the perfect pass, and nothing has ever felt so good. The setter gets the ball, goes straight to her, she makes a perfect set, and we get a kill, winning the game. After a long, hard fought battle. That is one of the most amazing feelings to have, and it shows how important passing is to the game of volleyball. In fact, passing is the foundation of volleyball. If you can't get a good pass, you can't get a good set, which means you can't get a kill, and ultimately takes away your chances of winning the game. And if you refer to your handout, all of these will come in the series if you're on your way. There are many ways and aspects to passing, but today I'm just going to show you the simplest form of passing, and I'm going to give you three easy steps to make a good pass. You want to focus on your stance, your platform, and your follow-through. Before you begin passing and playing the game of volleyball, there are a few things you want to make sure you have first. You want to make sure you're dressed appropriately. So you want to have an athletic t-shirt on, as you see here. You want a pair of athletic shorts that allow you to move freely and quickly. And then a couple things that are not necessary but are recommended are volleyball shoes, and they allow for extra traction and are made specifically for the game of volleyball, so they make your life a lot easier. And also ankle braces, because in the game of volleyball there's a lot of quick and random movements and people will flying everywhere, and it's very easy to roll and twist your ankle. And then one of the most important things to wear for volleyball is knee pads, because you spend a lot of your time on the floor of volleyball, and wearing knee pads helps you to avoid injury. And now that you're appropriately dressed and well equipped to play your very best and avoid injury, we'll begin with how to pass the volleyball. So the first thing you want to work on is your stance. You want your right foot slightly in front of your left foot, with your feet shoulder width apart, as Hannah is showing. And then you'll want a slight bend in the knee to get you down low and ready for the pass, for the serve to come to you. You want your arms straight out in front of you. We call them campfire hands, because then we want them to be able to go up or down. And you want to be ready to take the ball any way it comes to you. Then, after your stance is completely ready, you're ready to move on to the next step. Your platform. Platform is important because it can be the difference between a good pass, a ball that comes and hits you in the face, a ball that goes way behind you and causing us to lose the point. You want a clear platform. You want the ball right in the cradle of your arms. You want it to hit with your arms at an angle so that you can choose your target and make the ball go exactly where you want. You don't want your arms too low, because if they're low, then you have to swing and the ball will go straight up in the air. You don't want it too high, because then again, the ball will just bounce right off and either die right in front of you or go straight up. The next thing you want to work on is making sure that you keep your arms completely still, which kind of goes into follow-through. With your follow-through, you will want many things to stay consistent to make sure that you make the best pass to you, so that you make the best pass possible. Follow-through, you will want to keep your knees bent, your arms straight out in front of you, and when the ball comes to you, you'll want to, instead of swinging your arms and moving your arms, you want to go straight up all the way through. So, I'll demonstrate now what a follow-through should look like. You see, she didn't completely swing her arms. She went all the way up and moved with the ball. This allows your pass to be more smooth and more controlled. If you swing your arms, which we'll show you an example of now, things get a little crazy. So, this is something you definitely want to avoid, because the goal of the passer is to get the perfect pass straight to the setter so the setter doesn't have to move. The setter is the person who makes the offensive play and chooses where the ball goes and who gets the ball when. It goes to the front row and the hitter takes it, and then it's up to the hitter after that. But ultimately, the passer is most important because they start out every play. So, now we're going to kind of run back through all the steps to a good pass. You want your feet shoulder width apart, right foot in front of the left. You want your slight bend in the knees, arms straight out in front of you, ready for anything that can come to you, and you want your platform completely ready, and you want to just be very still and ready for the ball. And so now I'll show you again what the perfect pass should
Nice.
As you see, she moves smoothly with the ball, let her body be relaxed and calm, and she stayed very controlled, which allowed for a controlled high pass to the setter. So, and there are many different types of passing and other types that, there are many different types of passing, and many of these steps apply within other types of passing, and other types are such as digging or pancaking, and I'm going to kill Anna now, and I'm going to give you an example of how these apply, like all these steps that I just showed you apply even when you are digging or pancaking. So first we'll start out with a dig. Okay. Notice she kept her arms still, she kept her platform and her knees bent, and she stayed consistent, and it went straight to me. Now we're going to do a pancake, which is very hard, and this is why I have Anna here, because she's my libero. And she's very good at it, so. Okay, we'll try again. It's very hard, I'm serious. And as you see, there's just a slight hit of the hand, but she stayed completely ready until the ball got there, and that's why you need to have the consistent body motion and stance, because that way you can make a last minute decision and be calm and collected through the play. Blood ball is a great game to play. It causes you to be mentally determined and strong. It allows for a team to become a family, and it allows you to play with integrity and play, give everything you have and leave it on the floor. Now, passing is one of the most important steps to volleyball, and I hope that the next time you find yourself watching a game or even playing a game, you'll remember how important it is and the foundation of volleyball to the foundation of volleyball and how it's not as simple as you think. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause. Thank you, Katie, and thank you, Anna. We appreciate your time.